Let me hold you tight, only for one night. Let me keep you near to ease away your fears. I'll be at your side, if only for one night.
You are witnessing live the incomparable Chuck Rhodes.
I won't tell a soul.
One of my swimmers has grown up and
no
become
one has
a successful balladeer in the area.
If you want
this
to
is the son
be
of the legendary singer Darlene Mitchell.
Totally
shout out to his sister Chantel.
I'll be at your side.
You're going to get to see him live.
If only for one
at Lepus Live at the Work on December the 10th. Bow ties, gowns, and cocktail dresses.
Yes, sir.
Wear any colors you want. It's not a black tie affair. It's our first annual holiday special. All proceeds to go to a nonprofit. And we've just been blessed to have our native son, Chuck Rhodes, to come to the community and grace us with his neo soul, R&B, smooth night. And the ladies are just going to go crazy. Now, Chuck, welcome up to the studio on Lepus Live. Now, did you ever come, when you were younger, did you ever come on the TV show?
I've been on here close to 20 years ago.
Okay.
I think, did some music back then. I had my keyboard.
Okay.
Yeah, I remember that.
You see, I can't even remember all the people I've interviewed
and
when they were on the show because I've done like 20,000 interviews. And a lot of them have grown up. You said, how long ago was that? When
it
you
had to be about 20 years ago.
Yeah.
I'll never forget it. I had it on a DVD.
And people are saying right now, you don't even look older than 20. See, he got older than 20. We know he's older than 20. But did you, you got this magnificent voice.
Thank you.
When we had our Lepus Live After Work Coming to America, you came up out of the audience, your mom came up out of the audience, and y'all turned that mother out.
That's what we do. We show up and show out. That's what we do. Yeah, music.
So I was standing back in the wing like Don Cornelius from Soul Train.
Yep,
I said, I gotta figure out how to feature him. He had the little hood on and everything. Yep. It was smooth, man.
Yeah.
I knew he had some skills, but I didn't know he had that kind of skills now. Talk about the early days of you singing. Did your mom get you into singing? Your whole family, all of you sing like that?
Oh yeah, my mother, choir director, Mount Hermon Church. Even on my father's side, a lot of those guys were musicians up in the Bradenton, St. Pete area.
Okay.
So my grandfather, Jerome, he was also a singer. So
it just runs through the family.
Runs through the family.
Now, you were playing around as a kid, or you can't remember when you first started, you were just always singing, like in choirs and things like that.
I remember being maybe 5, 6 years old in the church choir, and then I pulled away from it because I wanted to be an athlete. I gravitated towards sports. I didn't want nothing to do with music for years until I got to North Fort Myers High School and I sung Jagged Edge on the school news. I had my jersey on, but I sung Jagged Edge and I got a lot of positive response from the ladies.
That'll get you every time, right?
Let me pull this, back into my focus for music. And then I met a guy who's had a huge impact on me right here in Fort Myers. David Christian, he showed me how to play the
keyboard. My man David, okay.
He showed me how to play the keyboard, and everything I do musically, I basically patterned after him and my mother, Darlene.
So you're going to drop a little keyboard on us on December 10th?
I should be able to do that.
I'm looking forward to that, man.
Yep.
Now, you say you did a little Jagged Edge.
Yep.
I love to get musicians to do stuff off the cuff.
Yeah, 90s.
All right, let's go back to just a little bit from that Jagged Edge that you did.
Oh, Jack, what was that? Gotta Be. I think that was their hit. That was their hit back in the 90s.
Can you give me a little acapella?
Yeah. I gotta be the one you love. Baby, I gotta be the one you touch. I gotta be the one you feel. And I gotta be the one. I can't even remember all the words. Yeah.
But here's the cool thing about that. See, we don't have any kind of special effects.
Yeah,
nobody
yeah.
mixing anything. You a real singer.
Thank
you real music. I could call out something. You could do it off the cuff. And that's what's missing nowadays. People who were really trained like you.
Yeah.
So do you get that kind of feedback all the time? Like hearing real music?
I haven't done music consistently. Throughout the years, I was a minister of music.
Okay.
Just for a few years here in Fort Myers and also up in Atlanta. So majority of the time I was in church singing, so people would always come up after church, you know, great job.
Okay.
Every now and then I would get to do a show similar to what you did. And then also in college, I was in a band, Florida A&M. We had a band there. So we did a lot of performances around Tallahassee. And we also performed in New Orleans one year around the Essence Festival time.
Okay, so people are seeing us on television now. They're also going to be listening to you on my radio show,
right,
which airs on Dunbar Gospel Radio. So
okay,
a lot of the gospel people are hearing you now, saying you, they heard you say that you did some things
yeah,
in the church.
Yeah.
So let me drop a little church music, a little gospel on right quick.
One of my favorite church songs was Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
Man, you right up there.
I can remember those words.
Man, you right up there with Kurt Franklin
the
Winans and Peebo Bryson, man.
Yeah,
who do you listen to? Who are some of your favorite artists?
Honestly, I listen to every type of music, but
okay,
my favorite voices have been one, David, I spoke of.
David Christian. David, you're getting a lot of love,
yeah,
man. David, bad boy.
Yeah,
local.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's the biggest influence. He's the best voice I've heard in person ever, I think.
Really?
Yeah. And then my mother right behind that. Between him and my mother, it was like growing up in that environment, you couldn't help but catch it.
Mm-hmm.
But outside of that, professionally, I like Daryl Coley was a gospel artist. I love Dino from H-Town.
Mm-hmm.
I patterned myself after him early on. Luther Vandross, I love his beautiful tone. And there's a neo-soul artist, Bilal. I would say those were the biggest ones I listened to.
Now, when you were a little boy in my swimming class at the Stars Complex, were you already singing at that point yet?
Probably so.
Or playing around?
Or messing around. I didn't know what it was. I thought, honestly, when I was young, I thought everybody could do what I did. It was just like, it wasn't special.
It, right.
And the focus, again, started being on sports, because this is a big football time.
Right,
so,
right. It's,
you know,
big.
Football was first, and the music, I was like, I'll get to that whenever.
Okay, let's talk a little football. You did okay in football?
I did decent. This is an area, I mean, Dion was the biggest thing, Fort Myers,
mm-hmm,
you know, in general, across the board, not just sport. So he kind of set that expectation for excellence, no matter what you did. Like, we knew we weren't all going to be that.
Mm-hmm.
But I went to North High School because he went there. That's the main reason I wanted to go there. I found his locker that I wanted
really?
To have. I had his same locker. And his mother's close friends of ours, Miss Connie, she always was just a very down-to-earth person, because, you know, Dion's so successful still to this day. But they were always, you know, good people, and he was just inspiring to, mm-hmm, you know, from a sports and across the board.
But you seem to have a really good foundation as a human being.
Thank
Talk
you.
About the values, the foundation. I think you grew up in Mount Hermon.
Yep.
Did you go to Mount Hermon Christian School as a kid and get your foundation education like Chantel mentioned?
No, I didn't go there, but I was in church quite a bit.
Mm-hmm.
And I would speak to the contribution from my mother and my grandmother in terms of character development. And so it was always a loving environment we grew up in. We probably didn't have the most money and all of the things that, you know, we would want in terms of material things, but we always had love in our home, you know, and mm-hmm, some material things as well.
Mm-hmm.
But that foundation of love and just warmth and just having a good heart. My grandmother especially, she had me going and taking cakes and pies to the neighbors, and, you know, she was, you know, from the old school, and I'm 40 now, so I could become old school pretty soon here. But But those were the days where people were just, our particular family, and it felt like the community was a warm, inviting place that just cultivated that character development.
Now, some of your classmates, people you grew up with right now, they're seeing you right now, and they're saying, well, what's Chuck Rhodes up to now? I think you're living in Atlanta,
yep.
And you get back here as often as possible,
yep.
Married with a couple of kids now, right?
Yeah, well, a couple of kids, no longer married, but mm-hmm. I was married, and I've been gone. I moved in 2011.
He's single, ladies.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
So, yeah, for work, I'm a clinician. I'm a licensed clinical social worker, so I'm a mental health therapist.
Okay.
And I've done some medical sales in the past. For the past few years, I was in pharmaceutical sales, medical device, and then recently I came back into the mental health space because of the pandemic brought a lot of, you know, people, you know, the awareness of mental health came up, brought a lot of people into mental health, so it's a exciting time that I can get to use my license and get into the mental health a little bit more these days.
You mentioned FAMU. You went to school there?
I went to Florida A&M.
So you got a degree. Talk about, I want people to know you got a solid education background.
Oh, yeah. So North High graduate, and then I went off to UCF actually for a couple of years, but I graduated from Florida A&M. I came back to Fort Myers and worked for a few years. And then I got my master's in social work from Florida Gulf Coast. And then I went up to Atlanta shortly after, and that's where I pursued the licensure mm-hmm. for clinical social work. So I was able to practice independently in mental health. So I've been doing that up there in Atlanta for 10 years.
All right, man, we're proud of you. When you do Lee Pitts Live after work on December the 10th, you'll be, I think you're going to have a band there and the whole works, right?
Yeah, I have a few friends of mine that I haven't played with in years, and I look forward to that, yeah.
What kind of music can we expect? What can we expect that night, holiday season?
Oh, it's going to feel good. It's going to feel like a FAMU Atlanta / Fort Myers Finest R&B Christmas vibes. Just, you know, real music. That's what I would describe. I don't knock any generation of music, but I'm a big fan of the 70s, 80s, 90s R&B. Mm-hmm. And that's what I listened to growing up. Those are the voices that, you know, I went to bed at night listening to, mm-hmm. woke up the next morning singing. So it'll be some of that. It'll be the Donny Hathaway. You might hear some Earth, Wind, and Fire, Prince. You mm-hmm. know, and I'm still putting it together now.
You're wrong, you're dead or wrong, babe. there's nowhere to hide, babe. So let love have its way, girl, to your heart, babe. When love calls, there's nowhere to hide, yeah. When love is calling your name, you fall apart, baby, baby. There's nowhere to hide, babe. So let love have its way, girl, to your heart, babe. When love calls your name, babe. Calling out for you, babe. Love's on its way, baby, baby. It's calling out for me. It's calling out for me, babe. Baby, it's calling out for you. It's calling out for you, babe. Let love have its way, baby, baby.
Thing, man, it's going to be in the holiday season, so you're going to drop us a little holiday. When you mentioned Donny Hathaway, I couldn't help but think about This Christmas. Yeah, give me a little This Christmas.
Oh yeah, that's the classic. Hang on the mistletoe, I'm gonna get to know you better this Christmas. And as I look around, your eyes outshine the town they do. This Christmas, I'm thinking about hanging the Christmas tree when I get back to Atlanta.
Tell me you're going to be able to bring Mom up out the audience. She got to pop up down
something.
Oh, yeah,
it's going to be some surprise.
She thinks she's going to surprise me.
I had a singing group also.
She got to do it last, though. I know she got her little stuff she wants to do, but she got to do it last. She kills that Etta James.
That's a staple. Yeah, we'll have fun.
Your generation talk about some This Christmas. You know people like Donny Hathaway. Those were real singers, huh?
Absolutely, yeah.
Being back and forth from Fort Myers, being in Atlanta, talk about Fort Myers is still in your DNA. When you come back, you feel revitalized in some kind of way, and your kids get to see where you grew up and things like that.
Yeah, this is home. I mean, it's grown over the last 10 years since I left, and I didn't really appreciate some of the benefits of being in a small town. Because Atlanta's, it's a lot of opportunities there, but it's overwhelming at times where, you got something going on the north side, take you an hour and a half to get to the south side, and it's just no family there ultimately to spend time with when you just want to kick back with people that you know and love. So Fort Myers is, I believe, is one of the most special places to come from. And like they say, New York City, they say you make it here, you can make it anywhere. I think Fort Myers is the same way, because the type of people we have, I think it's in the water, it's like.
Tell me about the feel that you had when you came into Lee Pitts Live after work. Did it have like a big city feel to it when you came to coming to America, feeling like, hey, all these black people in here on one accord, having a great time, listening to some nice music and food. It was just, it kind of had a big city feel. That's what I'm trying to do with it.
Yeah, well, a big city feel can go either way, but what I picked up on was black excellence. And that's what Atlanta is known for.
Right.
Well, that's what it felt like when you can come in a place where you don't have to worry about violence. You can network, you can meet people to inspire you and just, show genuine interest and concern, have a good time, have a drink, have a laugh, catch up, talk about potential for the future like we've been doing here and with people that you trust. So I would say a big city, you may not have all of that because it's random people from all over the world. But people here, you kind of know their auntie, you know their cousins, yeah, okay. And you can be like, all right, if you're doing something positive, I'm doing something positive, we can pull that together.
Yeah, you may not know this, of course you wouldn't know it, but I actually went to graduate school in Atlanta. Good. Atlanta University, what you know as Clark AU
Clark.
Center.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I got my master's degree there, nice. Coming over from Alabama, and so I spent a lot of time there in the ATL.
Yeah.
Fort Myers still has, Miami has the oranges.
The oranges,
by the way.
Yeah.
And Fort Myers got the what?
We got a whole lot of juice.
We got the juice. Anyway, yeah. Talk about this outfit, man. I can't let you get away, you know, all the way down skinny. If you can get a shot of those socks, they're like a piano. Yeah. And he got on some nice little moccasins. And he just clean.
Just
he Dolly,
and white,
you
man.
Darlene Turner clean, man. Yeah. Darlene Mitchell, now Darlene Mitchell clean.
Yeah, black and white.
Presentation and everything. Mom taught you that.
Yep, just clean and simple. You know, I don't try to do too much.
Work him all the way up, skinny. Work him all the way up.
They always say that, the man makes the clothes. The clothes don't make the man, you know. Mm-hmm. So whatever it is, you got to wear it with confidence.
That's a nice little thread, though, man.
You thank you very much. Thank you very much. Yeah, this, you know, this Atlanta, one of my favorite Atlanta suit stores. You can get hooked up real nice.
Okay.
You know.
A lot of stuff in there. What's the name of it?
K&G.
Okay, K&G. Get all the clothes right here on LinkedIn Live.
ATL. Uh-huh.
Okay, well, man, it's been a pleasure having you on the show. Kids are looking up to you right now, and I want you to kind of just talk, encourage the kids and let them know that they can be anything they want to be, to set their mind to it.
Well, yeah, Fort Myers, again, like I said earlier, to the young people, children here, this is one of the most special places. You may not feel like it all the time, but if you take advantage of what people try to pour into you and just keep a curious mind, you can go anywhere from Fort Myers. This is one of the most special places, I believe, in the world. And I'm proud to call it home. Glad to be back. I look forward to being back a little bit more, getting involved in the community, especially with my sister coming to the forefront. I'm super proud of her.
Running for city council.
Yeah, running for city
Ward
council.
3, Chantel Rhodes Club.
My mother Darlene, my stepfather Sam, my grandmother was a huge impact on me. I spoke about, she passed away, Bertha, but her and my grandfather Jerome, they were very influential. And I feel like everywhere you go here, it's always a smiling face. But I'm just very excited for the opportunity coming up in December and excited to be here with you today, man.
Okay, man. Well, look, I'm gonna let you start thinking in your mind a little music you're going to sing to take us off the air. While he's thinking about that, I want to remind everybody that on December the 10th, you don't want to miss this. We're going to have him in concert at Lee Pitts Live After Work. That's our Bow Ties, Gowns, and Cocktail Dresses edition, the first annual holiday at the American Legion Post 38. It's only $5 at the door, free parking outside, free food once you get inside, free photos, free everything. The vendors all around the walls. If you haven't experienced Lee Pitts Live After Work, you just haven't experienced Fort Myers. What do you got for me? Take us off there.
Let's do some John Legend.
Okay, give me about 45 seconds of that. You got the stage, bro. Give him a tight shot.
Girl, I'm in love with you. This ain't the honeymoon. We're past the infatuation phase. Right in the midst of love. Sometimes we get sick of love. Seems like we argue every day. I know I'm misbehaving. You made your mistakes. We both still have room left to grow. And though love sometimes hurts, I'll still put you first. We'll make this thing work, but I think we should take it slow. We're just ordinary people. We don't know which way to go. 'Cause we're ordinary people. Maybe we should take it slow. Take it slow. Slow. This time we'll take it slow. Take it slow. Slow. This time we'll take it slow.
Lee Pitts Live is a Lee Pitts Enterprise production.
Hello, everybody. This is Lee. I'm so glad that you watched that particular show. And if you enjoyed that show, we got other shows like that. Just subscribe to our YouTube channel, watch Lee Pitts Live on demand anytime, and also hit us up on all our social media platforms. Just type in Lee Pitts Live, and there you go.